Hi, Chris Chinnock here, Inside Media. It's DisplayWeek 24. I'm in the JBD, the Jade Bird Display booth. They are probably one of the leaders in microLED at this point. In particular, they're focused on supplying what they call their hummingbird display module for AR glasses. So this module is about a 0.4 cubic centimeter sized device. It's very small, and it uses 3.17 inch RGB microLED displays, and those are combined within an X cube combiner, very similar to what's used in LCD projectors, but this is obviously very tiny, that goes into a waveguide of some sort, and can produce a full color image. Now, they said they've got about 25 to 35 customers right now worldwide, but they said right now China is doing much better in terms of sales and sell-through than are some of the North American markets and well, other world markets, let's say. So what's going to happen when, in terms of development efforts? That point four cubic centimeter device is going to shrink to about 0.3 cubic centimeters by the end of the year. And they're also going to increase some of the performance of it. So let's see. Right now, that is they're getting about 3 lumens out of that little engine. 3 lumens doesn't sound like much, but it's enough for, well, for indoor applications, let's say. It's not going to be enough for outdoor applications. It's going to go to 4 lumens by Q4 this year, and they're right now they're able to get out from each device about red is about 1 million nits, green is 8 million nits, and blue is 1.5 million nits, and that's using a 4 micron pixel pitch. Let's see. In development is a monolithic full color microLED display. So the current device, as I said, uses 3 separate panels. The monolithic full color will end up using is basically stacking 3 different epi layers on top of each other. So red stacked on top of green, on top of blue, or I'm not sure exactly what the configuration is going to be. Those are going to be on a 5 micron pixel pitch. So the actual LEDs themselves, micro LEDs, are about 2.5 microns or so. And it's going to be RGB. So stacking gallium nitride red, blue, and green on top of indium gallium aluminum phosphide red, different material system, is going to be very challenging from thermal coefficient of expansion, from defect, from registration purposes, all that stuff. Really challenging task. They're shipping engineering samples right now. That can get about 300,000 to 400,000 nits of white light out, but they hope they can get that up to perhaps 1 million nits when they've completed development. They are showing shipping engineering samples right now, but they're still not ready to releasing a product. They, like I said, they're showing a number of different glasses here from different customers. And that is expected to add another 25 to 35 more customers in the next 12 months. So clearly one of the leading suppliers for AR glasses for the indoor market.
They were also showing a piece of equipment for helping their customers to align and calibrate their little projectors in the waveguide. So this machine, and this is especially important for binocular displays. So for binocular solutions, you've got two projectors going into the waveguide for each eye. So one, you have to make sure those images are aligned, so there's no mismatch, that so it's pixel accurate. But two, there's also going to be variations in the luminance, the uniformity, and the color for each eye, because of how the light is transmitted in the waveguides. The waveguides are not identical, nor are the displays for that matter. So being able to optimize how that image is aligned and calibrated is really important for the industry. So they've developed a machine to do that, and this is something that they are now trying to sell to their customers. I think it's a really good idea. It is helpful for the industry, but it's going to be an expensive machine to start, perhaps up to $1 million. So it becomes a business decision based on the volume of the devices that you're pushing through, the glasses, number of glasses that you're making, whether that's a justifiable investment. On the other hand, it's a really good way to get the quality that you need, because you're going to have to get that quality through some other means regardless. So kind of a nice innovation in the industry. We'll just see how well it's going to be adapted. That's Chris Chinna again for Insight Media.